Today's bed day. I'm just going to show you what our plans are. So these bits of wood, these were came off pallets, so these are extremely strong. Now the reason why we're going such depth on these is because the front of our van, this part here, is all this is fibreglass. So this, as you can see there, it's not weight bearing, this is purely just a front. So in order for us to sleep up here, we need to make a, I forgot what it's called, cantilever, that's it, cantilever system. So these are going to be our supports. They're not cut to size yet, we've got to cut them down. But what we've got to do is have a piece of wood coming this way across the front. There's like a little lip here, so we're going to cut grooves into this so this wood will sit in it, and it will sit, basically this is really strong here, so it can, the wood can sit on there. So its only points of contact will be this and a piece of wood on the front, and then the rest, all that is going to be hovering there. So with the longer pieces it's going to be even more, you can see there, so all that's going to be hovering. Now we're going to obviously have to make this really strong, this end, to hold all these in place so this can carry our weight. First job before the bed is built, them is bleaching. It might seem a bit excessive, but you can see the duct, we have cleaned this, but all this is properly in, and we're gonna spray foam on this, so we want to make sure it sticks to as much as we can. So we thought, what's the best thing to do? It's purely so Nem can just walk around with marigolds on, to be honest. Clean, they're new ones as well.
Yeah.
New cleaning marigolds today.
Yeah, I'm going to have one on like Popeye tomorrow. For my scrubbing.
Yeah, so we're going to... Nem's just giving it a good scrub. And then what I'm going to do is start measuring bits of wood. And lay out, I'm going to lay it out on the floor and build a bit of a framework so we can just drop it in.
Woohoo!
This is the progress. So far we've discovered that we've built the strongest wardrobe in the world. So that's the bed frame. That's going to be like a little wardrobe. And we do believe this could survive a nuclear disaster. It's very strong. So we've made it out of CLS timber. So it's 38 by 63 mil. And then we've also got these big bits of timber, which were bits of pallet wood. So yeah, that's the frame so far. So we've got to then put, hang on, get one, these bits of wood. Slide those on there, and that's how it's going to go, and all being well. So it's cantilevered, like you can see, so it's only fixed to this part here, which is why we've put these in. So we're going to put some glue there, multiple fixings, and then we've got to put a piece of wood on the front, and that's going to be our cantilever bed, all being well. We're not putting any supports between, because when we put a sheet of ply or whatever on top, that will stop them from moving. There's no point in putting extra weight on top. And that noise you can probably hear, is this little beauty hard at work? I promise I do work. I'm always recording, but you never see me actually doing anything. It's always you. So I promise I do actually work.
quite cosy.
Yeah, the ceiling's going to be so close to our faces.
Ta-da! Like magic, there's our frame. So the bed frame, we say complete, probably 90% done. So you can see there, the cantilever, what we're talking about. So this bit is not actually touching this fiberglass area. It's purely cantilevering off this. This is all glue. So we've built this really sturdy frame, fixed it with some big screws from underneath with loads of glue. Basically that is our bed frame. There we go. So this little bit here is gonna be like our little wardrobe. So that'll be enclosed area there. And then that's part of the seat. So that's the L-shaped seat there. So we'll sit in that bit and have like a little, it's like a little den. But yeah, our main priority was making sure this was sturdy, so we've had to use quite a bit of wood, like say CLS timber, and this thicker timber on top, just to make sure it's sturdy. And then this part of the door there, you can see how it's gone over the door. We're not actually going to use, door shut. That piece of the door is going to be kept open, and this is closed, so I mean, it's 600 mil, it's big enough for a door there. That's pretty much it for that part. And then once it's insulated, the insulation is only going to go onto this part, and then obviously insulate it all around the roof. And then we can get the board in on there, and that bed part is done. Now, from before, you may remember we had these bits of wood here that were fixed in and fixed to this. We've took those out. Now, when we tested it, it worked, but there was a bit too much flex in the end of here. Like, I mean, it was only a couple of mil, but over time, if you're putting a lot of pressure on wood, obviously we will be when we're sleeping, there's two of us going to be sleeping up there. It's not great, and obviously if it does get damp, it can get into the wood. So, yesterday when we had a bit of a rummage, we found this piece of aluminium, which originally was attached to the wall there, along there, and it was used as like a bit of a crash barrier, so when they were loading the van, it didn't hit that panel, because that's the external panel, so it hit that instead. Now this is extremely strong, because the way it's, I'm going to try and show you, because the way it's designed like that, it doesn't bend. I've stood on it and jumped on it, and it doesn't bend when it's sort of cantilevered. So what we're going to do, exactly like the wood, we're going to cut pieces to the length here. We're going to install another piece of this CLS timber there, double thickness, and we're actually going to bolt it in place. So it's going to work exactly like the wood. So it's going to hover over this fiberglass, because we can't put weight on this fiberglass, as you can see. We'll just fall through it and crack it. We've got enough of this to cut down and use. And it's lighter than the wood, because it's aluminium, it's very light. And also, it's about 20 mil slimmer. So we're actually, where the other wood was 70 mil, this is about 50 mil. And when you've got the bed space as cozy as that, 20 mil is quite large. So even though we're kind of having to go backwards a little bit, we're going to make it much better, because obviously we don't want to be doing it again. So first job we've got to do is put another piece of timber alongside this one, so it's double thickness, so it gives us a bit more thickness really, just to bolt through. Obviously if we'd have decided this from the start, we'd have just used thicker wood, to be honest. But with van conversions, it doesn't matter how much planning you do, there's always little hiccups and changes. You've just got to overcome them. So what we're doing, we're using this stuff, look, PVA. I think this is from Travis Perkins, if you're in the UK. This is another free item we had off a friend who had some building work done. They just left a whole tub of PVA adhesive, which is amazing. So with PVA, it's just a good adhesive, a wood glue. Now, if anyone's got any worries about PVA sticking, don't, because this wood is never coming off. I've smashed it with a chisel, as you can see, trying to get in. The only way to get this off is to physically split the wood. Like, the PVA is not coming away from the wood there. The only bits that did come away was the bit glue between that and this CLS timber. But between these two, we actually caked it in PVA. And that is extreme. To be honest, it's probably stronger than screws, weirdly. So yeah, just a note that is. But only use it for like construction. So obviously all this is not going to be seen. It's all pretty much going to be hidden behind paneling or anything. Because once it dries, you can't really sand it down so it looks nice. You want to use some proper wood glue, which you can then sand and paint. Because you can't really oil on top of this, because this creates a bit like of a waterproof barrier kind of thing. So when you're oiling, you'll see all the marks and it looks naff. So what you want to do is, what we do is just put it in a jar like that. I've already caked it in this, but I'll just show you. Just literally cake it on. Don't worry about there being loads. You can see how much we've put on here. Absolutely loads. Oh, I haven't done the end. Basically do every bit of wood that's going to come in contact with another piece of wood. So do all the ends, but just cake it on and then just get a rag after and wipe any bits that come off. But it's better to have more on. Every bit of surface area will stick then. So we're just going to put that piece in there, screw it in, and then do another one there. We are. So you can see there we've got double thickness now. So we've just got to do the same for this one here. You'll see I'll use some clamps then. It's worth getting some. These actually came with our Magnuson flip out table. And they're amazing. Like I said, I did there, just using them just to hold the wood in place while you screw it. Saves employing an octopus to give you a hand to, well, give you lots of hands. So yeah, get yourself some of these, they're great. Where the wood sat, and obviously it was only about 73 mil, whereas the metal beams are about 150 mil. So we've just cut that. This is just like a metal lip which keeps this in place. We've done, you can see a bit there, we've just put some silicone all the way because this was just loose basically. Once we've took all, there was like a metal frame on here, we've took all that off. 150 mil, and you can see now what we mean. So that sits flush with the wood. It's not resting on the metal. So obviously it's sat flush on top of this wood and it extends over to there. So what I'm going to do now is cut this along and then we'll bolt into this wood then. And then secure it onto this wood. Probably just use screws on this wood because this is only holding the weight, whereas this one, this whole thing is trying to lift up that way. So obviously as the weight's pushed on this end, it's going to pull this end upwards. So this is just weight bearing, which is plenty strong enough. So yeah, got to go and cut these now. We'll be right back. metal aluminium support in place. That's where it's going to sit. So what we're going to do now is bolt it to this. So we're going to get a bolt through there. The reason we're bolting is just because they're a lot more, because there's got a lot of strength needed, you know, to hold this in place. Bolts are just better than screws, really. So we'll all need a screw. It's just a screw there, just so it stays sat on this piece of wood. But like I said before, that's weight bearing, so it's not like this end where this is trying to, you can see there, it's trying to pull up. So we need to fix it so it's against the wood. And obviously trying to pull a bolt apart is pretty impossible. So what we've done with the bolts is, instead of buying bolts that length, because we're going to be, sorry, I've got my new pointer here. So because we're going to have bolts through here, which are about 80 mil, we're also going to have bolts to put on the frame of this to fix to that. Also, we're going to have bolts under the van, which is why I've got this threaded rod as my trusted pointer. So if you can see, in fact, I'll put it down so you can see what I mean. So a threaded rod, this is M8 threaded rod, you can see there. And then all you need are nuts, and the nuts go on the threaded rod. So instead of buying bolts specific size, we've just bought threaded rod in meter lengths. See, that one's a meter. And all we've done is just cut them down. So it takes a bit more graft. However, you can make them exactly the right size you need. So we've got these 80 mil. So it just means you haven't got to buy loads of different types of bolts, which generally come in, you know, big packs, so you end up with loads of waste. So this way we can cut these exactly the length we need. And then we've got normal nuts, just hex nuts, and we've also got what they call nylon hex nuts. If you don't know what nylon nuts are, these ones are, sorry, let's try and get a focus on it. They've got a little piece, you can see the nylon in there, that blue bit. So that means it's sort of like a locking nut, so it won't come loose with that. And then we also have washers, a pack of washers there. Yeah, and a tip for making your own nuts and bolts. Done is just countersunk the hole, just so the washer and the nut now sit flush. So you can see there, it's not sticking out, sitting nice and flush. So just do the other side, then we get the top piece on. Ta-da!
I like doing that because stuff gets done. So the bed frame is finished now. Again, I'll just show you what we've got then. So these, you can see here the bolts, the washers, and then underneath, you saw us doing, we've just countersunk. So we've just drilled a bigger hole, 25 mil I think that hole is. And then there's a washer inside with a bolt and the threaded rod, the makeshift bolt. So they're in there. And then at the back here, we've just pre-drilled and put a long screw and washer in either side. And that's the same for all of them. So these three in the middle, what you can see there, those three are about the same length. The ones on the ends are slightly shorter because of the curve. So you can see we've got the curve there. And yeah, I've not actually tested it yet. I'm quite excited. But you can see, if I did that with the wood before, you'd see it slightly bow. Whereas this stuff is not moving. And it's rock solid on there now, with obviously, now we've put double CLS on. So that is great. Took a bit longer than expected today with this. I wanted to get a bit more done, but it's done. And I've been on my own today because Nemi's been hard at work in the office, bless her. Well, when I say office, I mean, there she is, look, just in time. There she is. There she is, look, the office buddy. So I'm keeping an eye on her, making sure she's working, and she's probably doing the same with me. Yeah, there she is, looking, watching in case she picks her nose. No, she's not going to pick her nose. We'll leave her in peace. So yeah, Nem's just been spending the day catching up on emails and doing a bit of work on the blog and doing a new post. So that's exciting. If you're new to the channel and you don't know us, we're obviously Van de Camp Adventures. And we have a blog, which I'll put the link to below. It's in all our videos. So check it out. It's anything to do with van conversions, and then eventually it'll get to travelling. So we want to make the experience, this experience, available for everyone. Doesn't matter your background, who you are, anything. This is possible for everybody. So yeah, Nem's been good and working, which is where I would be if we didn't have all this work to do as well. So generally, once we finish this on a night, I then sit in the office and do work as well until midnight hours. So that's what our life is at the moment. But yeah, if you're interested in finding out more, go to the blog. There's an About Us. Check us out. And obviously Instagram as well. We're on there. Well, we try to be on there as much as we can. Unless we're having too much fun, as always. So yeah, thanks for joining us.